What is up, all my chill gamers? So yeah, I just beat the yellow Wind Sage. It was took me a little while. It took me like 15 tries, you know, trial and error, working on his move sets. But yeah, this is what I have equipped, guys, so you guys can see what I've been using and upgrading. I haven't really been upgrading a lot of martial arts things sections. I got the health, stamina, definitely the mana. Stances, I'm working on the smash. Not really too much thrust. I think I upgraded one thing with thrust. Not really. I've seen a lot of videos out here upgrading all this. I didn't need it, to tell you the truth. There's other ways to do it, obviously, because I seen like somebody upgrade all this. I'm like, oh, it's a lot easier. I'm like, it could be, but that's not my style. You know, I actually do my own style. So if you guys like this style, feel free to use it. The immobilize is not fully upgraded either. So, and the rock solid's just one, just that little, you know, that little one thing, you know. And the pluck of many spells fully upgraded. These guys are awesome. The duration is like 40 seconds, I believe, something like that, 30 to 45 seconds. Definitely a cool time. And I just upgraded this. Each talent level slightly reduces the Mike Decay while transform. Why? Because I transform as him, I'm doing a little bit more damage, and that's what I want to do. So there is one thing I want to do here soon, is this one. I gotta try to upgrade this as soon as possible, because, you know, more attack power than anything. Yeah, so this is what I've been using. It's been working really good for me. I think I'm level 58. I thought it was 55, but I'm 58 now. So again, you do want to make sure, if you have the stuff to craft, you definitely want to have the tiger subduing pellets to give you a little bit more extra boost in damage. You want to have the longevity. Definitely gives you a little bit more boost in health and stuff like that. I don't even think I use it here. I might have, you know, and I have the evil repelling medicate. Because this one, even though I have it on my gourd, that damage reduction, but once it goes away, I have this little backup just in case. So that's what I've been using, guys. So yeah, I'm actually on chapter 3. Going to get into that soon. And I hope you guys liked the video. So it is me beating the yellow Wind Mage. Wind Sage. Same thing, right? Same thing. In like 3.5 minutes, 4 minutes. And I think I only used the gourd once or twice, maybe once. I definitely did this. This is my best outcome, because all the other times I used all my gourds and I had nothing. So I figured out a way, and I used to use the pluck of many spell before it even started, which was kind of crazy. So what I figured out was, and you guys see here in the video shortly, that I actually cast them after he started moving the first thing. So it was pretty cool. But yeah, guys, check out the video and enjoy. And hopefully this helps out. Okay, guys, so here's the fight. Let's get into it. So here we go. The quick dodge. Quick dodge in the beginning here. I didn't use any immobilization or the duplicates just yet. So right now I'm about to do it. Get my little distance here, because it does take a few seconds for them to come up. Okay, they're up. And I'm about to use the mobilize. I'm gonna quick over there. Now I shouldn't use the transform, because the transform does break the immobilize spell. So that was kind of crazy on my part, because I actually got where, you know, my thing doesn't break when I hit them with the light attacks and everything. But yeah, so they're doing their job, I'm doing my job with the transform. Now with the transform red tides, I kept missing my hits. I was like, man, this guy keeps moving. So I had a little trouble here, but obviously I just keep close to him, keep hitting him, you know, with the transformation, just, you know, be on his, right there with him. Okay, now I was about to go away. Now mind you, I am taking damage, but I only heal like once or twice maybe. Obviously, yeah, I got hit there, I didn't dodge. Now he does that, you dodge twice, and all you have to do is really just stay on your toes, keep dodging, you know, stay close to him about. You'll know, like, you'll see when you have to come kind of far away from him to take a breather, to say, all right, let's refocus, let's regroup, so it's not going crazy for you. So I backed up right there just to catch my breath, and then, you know, he went close, I attacked, and he got me with that. I hate when he does the field goal kick, I'm gonna call it the field goal, because he does take half your energy. So be wary of that, like that right there. If he got you with that, that your half your energy is gone. So I'm always looking out for that. Got him with a few attacks there, some combos. Use the immobilize, get him as quick as you can. Now remember, I still have my L2R2 special, so, and I still have the Wind Tamer that you get. I'll probably make a video on that too, how to get that. So yeah, so that special knocked him down a little bit, gave him a chunk of his energy out, which is really helpful. So at this point, I still have enough, I believe, for the Rock Solid and the Immobilize, but I don't know. So at this point, I'm still dodging, still trying to, and again, this is my best run here. So I want to use, like, again, I think two heals. I have six altogether. So, and that's just it, guys. You want to stay close to him. You want to learn his move sets. Obviously, it took me like 10 to 15 tries, maybe 18 or 10 to 18 tries. It took me a while. And again, he got me with that. All you have to do is really just learn his move sets. Do it like 3 to 5 times if you're having trouble. Rock Solid block and just figure out his move set. Because people who go in here one or twice and they beat him, shout out to you guys. But it took me a little while. I don't know why this boss gave me so much problems, but he did, unfortunately. So again, stay close to him. Attack, attack, use your combos. And as he was putting up that Wind Tornado, that's when I really, really took advantage. And then I put out the Wind Tamer, another 10 seconds, 8 to 10 seconds rather. Maybe 12, I don't know, I didn't count. But it's definitely a good chunk in time. You could just definitely get combos in. So again, I stood back, dodged again. And it's basically timing, dodging, staying close to him, know when to attack, know when to dodge, know when to stay away a little bit, catch your breath, you know, refocus, regroup, and go and stay calm. Don't get nervous. People make mistakes when they get nervous. Right there, you know, he's going to do that move again. I should have dodged twice on that, but I didn't. I'm out of stamina, so he's going to hit me anyway. So yeah, he was jumping around. Oh my, come on, man, come on. So finally got him, guys. It's been one heck of a ride, but there you go. Yellow Wind Sage defeated. Like always, guys, stay chill. Happy game. See you all in the next one. Peace.